nuclear curve that we are going to see now. First, we are going to see the definition and the properties of Bezier curve, and then we will see how to draw the Bezier curve with given points. Definition of Bezier curve, it is a simple definition. A Bezier curve is mathematically defined curve used in two-dimensional graphic application. So mathematically defined curve, how the mathematical calculations are there, we are going to see here. The curve is defined by four points. The curve is defined by four points, the initial position and the terminating position. So if this is considered as a Bezier curve, then this is the first point, initial position, and this is the terminating position, which are called anchors. And two separate middle points, which are called handles, or we call that as a control points. So handles, these are the main on which the shape of the Bezier curve is depend. The shape of a Bezier curve is altered by moving the handles. For example, suppose this control point, I moved some point here, so the curve may be like this. If this control point or this handle is moved, then the curve may be like this. Means the shape of the curve can be altered by moving the handles. So the mathematical method for drawing the curve, this kind of Bezier curve, it is created or generated by Bezier in late 1960s for manufacturing of automobiles at Renault. And that's why it is known as Bezier curve, because it is generated by the Bezier. Now, the properties of Bezier curve we are going to see here initially. So properties of Bezier curve, the first property of the Bezier curve is that basis functions are real. That we are going to see afterward the function how to write. Bezier curve is an approximation spline curve. So there are two types of spline curve we have seen, interpolation and approximation. So interpolation means if there are four control points, then the curve passes through all the four control points. That we call as a interpolation, and that interpolation we have studied in detail with cubic spline curve. But the second way is the approximation curve, in which you can observe here that there are four control points and the curve passes through only two control points, the P1 and P2 not covered in this curve. So approximation curve, so Bezier curve, second and important property is that it is an approximation curve. Degree of polynomial is 1 less than the number of control points, means degree is n if there are n plus 1 control points. So the examples are given there, parabolic curve, here there are 3 control points, means n is equal to 2. If there are 3 control points, n is equal to 2. If there are 4 control points, n is equal to 3. Here n is equal to 3. Here n is equal to 3. Here n is equal to 4. So this is example of parabola curve. Cubic curve, when we call it is a cubic curve, when n is equal to 3, we call it as a cubic curve. So all these are cubic curves, and this is parabola curve. Along with that, the next properties of Bezier curve, curve generally follows the shape of defining polygon. So this is the polygon, this one we call these control points, this is the polygon. And the curve follows the shape of the polygon. Means if the curve polygon is like this, okay, then curve will be like this. The curve follows the shape of the defining polygon. The first and last point, that is very important feature of the Bezier curve, that first and last points on the curve are coincident with the first and last point of the polygon. So you can observe that the first and last points are there, coincident means this is considered. The middle points, it is to be there in the curve or not, it depends upon the mathematical equation. In this, you can observe this is the polygon, and the first and last point is coincident with the polygon, points of the polygon. curve passes through the first and last control point compulsory. The first and last control point is always there in the curve. The remaining point depends upon the mathematical equation. The curve is contained within the convex hull of defining polygon. So this is the convex hull. The curve is within the convex hull. You can observe this is the curve which is within the convex hull of the defining polygon. Then the next property, multiple control points at a single coordinate position gives more weight to that position. Means here this is the P0, the starting point, and this is P4, which is the end point. Now this P2 and P3, these two points are coordinate together. Okay, so as these are together, when they are together, it gives more weightage to that particular position, and that's why you can observe the shape of the curve is like this. If these points are like this, then the shape will be like this. But these two are comes together here and it gives more weightage to that position, and that's why the curve shape is changes here. The weight at that point is increased. Why? Because two multiple control points are coordinate together. Then closed Bezier curves are also there, which are generated by simple. Closed means first and the last control points at the same position. You can observe here, this is also a curve, but here it is a closed curve. Why? Because first and last points are at the same position. Then the next and last property, Bezier curves are tangent to their first and last edge of control polyline. Tangent vectors at the end of the curve have the same direction as the respective span. So you can observe that suppose this is the curve generated with this particular polygon, then the first and last edge, this is the first edge and this is the last edge, that are tangent to the polygon or that curve. And the direction, tangent vector direction, you can observe here, this is the direction, this is the direction. In this also you can observe first and last point. Here the direction of this curve is same as the direction of tangent vector. Direction of this curve is same as the direction of tangent vector. So first and last point decide the tangent vector direction, and accordingly the curve is generated. So these are the properties of Bezier curve. So always remember, most important properties of the Bezier curve is that the first thing, that it is an approximation curve. The first and last point is, there are four major points, initial and the last point, and middle control points are there. The control points define the shape of the curve. The control point define the shape of the curve. Then degree of the polynomial, if there are four control points, then n is equal to 3, degree 3. If there are four control points, then n is equal to 3. If there are five control points, then n is equal to 4. Means it is one less than the number of control points. Another thing is that it follows the shape of the particular polygon. Means if this is the shape of the polygon, then the curve is same shape. Then it passes through the first and the last control point always. The middle control points depends upon the mathematical equation. Everywhere you can see the first and the last control point is considered everywhere. Remaining control point decide the shape of that particular curve. Another thing, that the first and last point, the direction is same as tangent vector direction. So these are some basic properties of the Bezier curve when we draw the curve. And these are some typical example of cubic polynomial. Why it is called cubic? Because there are four control points and n is equal to 3. And that's why these are some example of cubic polynomial Bezier curves. Now, mathematically, how we define the Bezier curve, that we are going to see here, and the same equations we are going to identify the points on the curve. So mathematically, a parametric Bezier curve is defined by PT. What is PT? PT is the position vector that we know. PT is the position vector, that position vector point on the curve, any point on the curve. How we define that point on the curve, PT, is the summation of I is equal to 0 to n, means if there are 4 control points, so it is n is equal to 3. If there are 4 control points, then n is equal to 3, so I ranges from 0 to 3. I ranges from 0 to 3 means the value of I is nothing but n plus 1. 0 to 3, 0, 1, 2, 3 means 4 times or 4 points are considered here. Then BI, that is the basic function, or we call it as the Bezier function that we are going to calculate. So BI 0 to n, B1, B0, B1, B2, B3 up to BN. J of NI at position vector T, where T is 0 to 1. So when we consider this curve, this is the first point. Here T is equal to 0 and here T is equal to 1. And in between whatever the point, these are from 0 to 1. Greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 1. So first point is always 0 and the last point is always 1. And in between points on the curve are from 0 to 1. Where BI is the position vector, I is ranges from 0 to n, 0, 1, 2, 3. In example, n is equal to 3. And the Bezier curve or Bezier or Bernstein basis blending function, what we call that B. It, how this defined? For that, first we need to identify this function, J, N, I. T is N, I, T raised to I, 1 minus T, N raised to I. So we need to remember this is the function 1, this is the second equation. So this equation is, how we write this N? It is nothing but NCI. NI, how we write it is NCI, binomial coefficient. So what is the equation of binomial coefficient in mathematical term? It is N factorial divided by I factorial multiply with N minus I factorial. That is the standard equation. Means this Ni, we need to put this value here. So what is J N I T? This one multiply with this one. That is the function we calculate, J N I T. And the B ranges from the Bernstein function or the blending function, B0, B1, B2 up to Bn. So J N I T, what is it? Is the nth order. N is the nth order, means 3, 2, 1 in this way. Nth order Bernstein basis function. N is the degree of defining the Bernstein basis function polynomial curve segment. So N is equal to 3. So here we are identifying the nth order is the ith nth order basis function, means N J of 0. J of N comma 0 means it is 0th. Third order. Why third order? Because n is equal to 3. Bernstein function. And how identify that function? With these two equations. And that one we are going to put here and find out the position vector and the points on the curve. So here n is always less than the number of points used to define the Bezier poly curve. So n, there are 4 control points, then n is equal to 3. That already we have seen. It is the property of Bezier curve. So these functions we need to remember. First, how to find out the position vector, and in that position vector, how to identify J, N, I. Now here, we are going to see example, then it will be more clear to you how the J, N, I is calculated and how it is useful. So example I am going to show you here. With example it will be more clear to you how to identify the points on the Bezier curve. So blending function for three polygon points we are going to find out here. Blending function for three polygon points means three control points are there. If there are three control points, what is n? N is equal to 2, n plus 1 is equal to 3. Why there are three? And that we call it as a quadratic Bezier function. Quadratic, n is equal to 2, and that's why it is quadratic Bezier function. So I am going to write here the equation again that we have seen previously. Pt is equal to summation of I is equal to 0 to n bi, I ranges from 0 to n, j n I, ith n order t. And what is j n I t? J n I t is equal to n factorial divided by I factorial multiply with n minus I factorial and then multiply with t raised to I 1 minus t raised to n minus I. 1 minus t raised to n minus I. Now we put the values 0 to 2. Here we will get PT is equal to, so summation of BI 0 to N, N is equal to 2. So I start with I is equal to 0. The equation for J, N is 2 comma 0. N is equal to 2 comma 0 T plus B1 J of 2 1 T plus B2 J of 2 2 T. J of 2 2 T. So in this way we can identify the PT function. But for that, what we need to calculate? We need to calculate these values first. J of 2 comma 0 to J, t, J of 2 comma 1 t, J of 2 comma 2 t. So first we calculate Bezier or Bernstein basis or blending function. So first we calculate J of 2 comma 0 T. So J of 2 0 T, I am going to put the value. So in this case, what is the value of N? N is equal to 2, I is equal to 0. I write here this value so that it becomes easy to calculate and put the value. So N is equal to 2, I is equal to 0. What is the function for this? N factorial means 2 factorial divided by I factorial means 0 factorial. N minus I means 2 minus 0 again 2 factorial. Multiply with t raised to I, t raised to 0. The values of N and I am putting here. 1 minus t N minus I means 2 minus 0, 2. So try to simplify it. 2 factorial, 2 factorial, it is going to discard. 0 factorial, what is the value of 0 factorial? It is 1. The value of 0 factorial is 1. So, the first term 1, what is t raised to 0? T raised to 0 also 1. multiply with 1 minus t square. And that's why the answer is 1 minus t square. Similarly, we are going to calculate j of 2 comma 1 t. So here n is equal to 2 and I is equal to 1. N is equal to 2 and I is equal to 1. So put the values here. N factorial means 2 factorial divided by 1 factorial multiply with 2 minus 1 means again it is 1 factorial. T raised to I, T raised to 1, 1 minus T raised to N minus I means 1. So again, here 2 factorial divided by 1 into 1. So 1 factorial value is 1 again. So it becomes 2 factorial. What is the value of 2 factorial? It is 2. So the whole term, this whole term, the value is 2 multiply with T multiply with 1 minus T. And when we make it simple, it is 2T 1 minus t which is equal to 2t minus 2t square. So that is the value of j 2 1 t. Now the next one j 2 2 t. Now in this case n is equal to 2 and I is equal to 2. So put these values and we will get the value for this one. So it is, I am going to write here 2 factorial divided by I factorial means again 2 factorial n minus I means 0 factorial t raised to I t raised to 2 1 minus t raised to 0. So 2 2 discarded 0 factorial is 1 t square. 1 minus t raised to 0 is again 1. So the result is t square. So here we get the values of blending function, the function j for three values I ranges from 0 to 2. 0, 1, 2. Now all these values we are going to put together. Now put all these values here together, the main function. So pt is equal to p naught, correct, j 2 0. What is the value of j 2 0 t? It is 1 minus t square plus b 1. What is the value of j 2 1? It is multiply with 2t minus 2t square plus b2 multiply with j value of j2 2t is t square. So that is our position vector function. That is our position vector function. And that we will use to find out the value of x, t and y, t. What is the x, t and y, t? Xt and yt, these are the position vectors on the curve. That also we are going to see. Only here we are finding the position vector function pt. Now addition of, we are going to perform the addition of this basis function. This is to prove some theorem we are going to do. Addition of basis function. So summation of j, capital J, n, I, t, where I ranges from 0 to n. Means here we are going to perform the summation of 2, 0, t plus j of 2, 1, t प्लस जे ऑफ टू टू टी. The values already we have calculated previously, so I am going to put that value. It is 1 minus t square plus 2t minus 2t square plus t square, correct? That is these three trending functions already we have calculated. Now we are going to add this. So when I simplify this equation, it will be 1 minus 2t plus t square plus 2t minus 2t square plus t square. So it is 2t, 2t minus 2t plus 2t, it will be removed. Then minus 2t and this plus 2t square will be removed and we remains 1. Correct? I write it here minus 2t plus 2t for your 2t square minus 2t square. So these two are removed, these two are removed and remains 1. So here from this we can say that for any given value of parameter t, the summation of basis function is precisely 1. So I write it here. So from this we can say that for any given value of the parameter t, the summation of basis function blending function is precisely 1. Write it, summation of j, I ranges from 0 to n, n comma I t is equal to 1. So that is a proof. This question, this type. Now we are going to see here the detailed example to draw a Bezier curve. So given, there are four control points given here, P naught 1 1, P 1 2 3, P 2 4 3 and P 3 3 1. These four control points are given here. Are the control points or vertices of the Bezier polygon. Determine 7 points on the Bezier curve. So first here given the four control points. So I am going to draw here the control points here, the polygon first. How many points are given here? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, x and y. 1, 2, 3, 4. Maximum 4 is there. So first 1, 1. So it is the first, that is our V0. V1 is 2, 3. I am drawing here initially so that it becomes simple for you to understand what we are going to do. Then next one is 4, 3, somewhere here, B3 and 3, 1. 3, 1, it is somewhere here. That is, sorry, it is B1, it is B2, and this is B3, 0 to 3. This is our polygon. Clear? Now this polygon is given here. Now this is a convex hull for our curve. Means the curve will be here in this like this. Okay, so we are going to draw that curve. We are going to find out how many points are given there. 7 points we need to find out on this curve. Determine the 7 points. How to find out these 7 points? That we are going to see now. So before that, first what we need to do? Find out the bending function or basis function. So I am going to write the equation again here. The equation for Bezier curve is PT point summation I is equal to 0 to n PI JNI T, and where JNI T is equal to n factorial divided by I factorial multiply with n minus I factorial T raised to I 1 minus T raised to n minus I. Here, how many control points are there? 4 control points are there. So here n is equal to 3 as there are 4 vertices or 4 control points. Vertices or control points. So accordingly the equation for PT is B naught J of 2, 0 t plus B1 J of 2, 1 t plus B2 J of 2, sorry, here n is equal to 3 plus B J of B3 J of 3, 3 t. That is our equation, final equation with I is equal to 0, I is equal to 1, I is equal to 2, and I is equal to 3. That is our final equation. Before that, what we need to find out? We need to find out the value of J30T, J31, J32, and J33. That is blending function. First, we calculate Bezier or blending function. Okay, so first start with J of 30 t. J of 30 t. So here n is equal to 3, I is equal to 0. Put the values in this equation, previous equation. It will be 3 factorial divided by I factorial. N minus I means 3 factorial. Multiply with t raised to 0 means t raised to I. Multiply with 1 minus t raised to n minus I. So it is 3. So once we simplify it, this will be discarded as 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial. It remains 1 minus t raised to 3. So the final answer is 1 minus t raised to 3. Similarly, we need to calculate J of 2, 0 t. with n is equal to 3 एंड आई इज इक्वल टू 1। थ्री कॉमा वन टी, सो पुट द वैल्यूज, एन फैक्टोरियल डिवाइडेड बाय आई फैक्टोरियल मल्टीप्लाई विथ एन माइनस आई फैक्टोरियल टी रेस टू आई वन माइनस टी रेस टू एन माइनस आई। सो द रिजल्ट इज 6 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 मल्टीप्लाई विथ टी वन माइनस टी स्क्वेर, सो 3t 1 minus t square, or you can simplify it again, that is 3t minus 3t raised to cube. Next, in the same way, j of 3 comma 2t with n is equal to 3, I is equal to 2, which is n factorial divided by I factorial multiply with n minus I factorial t raised to I 1 minus t raised to n minus I is equal to, again the same, 6 divided by 2 t square 1 minus t, and when we simplify it, it is 3 t square 1 minus t, or you can again simplify it, which is 3t square minus 3t cube. Here also it is 3t minus 3t cube. Next, j of 3t. N is equal to 3, I is equal to 3. So n factorial divided by I factorial, and then n minus I factorial, so 0 factorial, t raised to I 1 minus t raised to n minus I means 0. So it is 1 multiply with t, 3 multiply with 1, so it is t raised to cube, t cube. So thus I write here, pt is equal to p naught, the first one is 3t minus 3t cube, plus P1 second, sorry, first one is 1 minus T cube, plus B1 3T minus 3T cube, plus B2 3t square minus 3t cube, plus b 3 t cube. Now here b naught, b 1, b 2 and b 3, what it is given, correct? The x and y values for that vertices or the control points are given. So putting that x and y value here, we are going to find out the 7 control points. Seven control points which we are going to identify. For that, the value of, what is the value of t? Because we are calculating J30t, correct? J31t, J32t, J33t. So these blending functions are there. So for that value, to what is the value of t, that we are going to put it here. Now that there are 7 points we have to calculate, determine 7 points, that is given there. So when we want to determine the 7 points, okay, Starting points. What is the starting point always? Always start with t is equal to 0 and end with t is equal to 1. So in between we need to identify the 5 points. Why? Because there are total 7 points are required. So we need to identify total remaining in between 5 points. So as there are total 7 points, how to find out these 7 points? For that, the maximum value is 1 divided by 0.07. Why? Because there are 7 points we need to find out. So when we perform this, it gives something point nearby 15, 0.15 value. Means we can take the difference of 0.15 in between all these points. Means after 0, the next point is here. After 0, the next point is 0.15. Then, so in this way, we have to write down the remaining point. Not necessary that exactly the every point is 0.15 difference. You can change it. So, as we need the 7 points in between, that's why. So, 0.5 I have taken, next one 0.65 I have taken, and next 0.85 I have taken. So, nearby 0.15 difference is there. Suppose another example, there are asked that you have to four points on the polygon. So you have to determine 4 points on that Bezier curve. So in that case, again, see t is equal to 0 initially and at the end t is equal to 1. So 1 divided by 0.04. So the result is 0.25. Means what? The difference should be 0.25. So the first point is 0, the second point is 0.25, the third point is 0.50, okay. And then 0.75. Sorry, if there are 5 points instead of 4, 0.5, then 1. So in this way, 5 points we can identify. These are the values of t. These are the values of t. With the help of this one, we are going to find out the remaining values of j. Now, putting this value of t with the equation of j of 3, 0. So what is j of 3, 0 here? So already we calculated that equation. What is j of 3, 0? J of 3, 0 is equal to 1 minus t raised to 3. It is equal to 1 minus t raised to 3. Okay. 1 minus t raised to 3. So put that value of t here in the first equation. In the first equation, it is 1 minus, what is the first value of t? It is 0. So, 1 minus 0 raised to 3. So, the result is 1. So, here in this case, j of 3, 0 is equal to 1. Now, put the same in the j of 3, 1. J of 3, 1, or you can complete the first column and then go for the second column. It is also work. So j of 3, 1 is equal to, what is j of 3, 1? The value we have already calculated, it is 3t 1 minus t square raised to 2. So put the value of t here. What is the value of t here? It is 0. So 3 multiply with 0. 3 multiply with 0. And whatever the remaining, the answer will be 0. Why? Because once we multiply it with 0, the result is 0. Means here, in this case, with j of 3, 1, the result is 0. Similarly, put the value of t in j of 3, 2. What is the j of 3, 2? It is 3t square multiply with 1 minus t.
What is the value of t here? The value of t is 0 here. So when we multiply 3 with this 0, in this case, the result is 0. So j of 3 comma 2 in the first row, it is 0. Similarly, j of 3 comma 3. So what is the value of j of 3 comma 3? It is t raised to cube or t cube. Sorry. T cube. What is the value of t here? It is 0. So 0 cube is 0. So the first column value is 1. The remaining all values are 0 for t is equal to 0. So I am going to put that values here. 1. It is 0. It is 0. It is 0. Now similarly we calculate when t is equal to 0.15. First start with j of 3 comma 0. So the j of 3 comma 0 is 1 minus t raised to 3, which is equal to, what is the value of t here? It is the 0.15. So 1 minus 0.15 raised to 3, and when we calculate it with the help of calculator, it is nearby 0.614. It is nearby 0.614, means when t is equal to 0.15, when t is equal to 0.15, what is the value of here j of 3 comma 0? The value of j of 3 comma 0 is 0.614. Similarly, we calculate the next, that is j of 3 comma 1 with the value of t 0.15. So j of 3 comma 1, its equation is 3t multiplied with 1 minus t raised to 2. So here, what is the value of t? It is 0.15. So 3 multiplied with 0.15. 1 minus 0.15 raised to 2. So when we calculate it with the help of calculator, it is 0.325. So when t is equal to 0.15, the value of J31 is 0.325. Similarly, we put the value of t 0.15 in J of 3 comma 2, and similarly we calculate the value of j of 3 comma 3. Okay, so that values are here, in it is 0.058. I have calculated previously already with the help of calculator, so here it is 0.003. So you putting the value of t as 0.15, we will get this value. Why we are calculating this table? So we are calculating this table to identify or to simplify the equation of pt, position vector, to identify the position vector, that equation, this equation we have to find out, correct? So to solve this equation, we need the value of j of 3 comma 0 for t, where t is either 0, 0.15, 0.35, 0.05, 0.65, 0.85 and 1. So every time for j of 3 comma 0 means 1 minus t cube, we put the value of t here and we will get this column. For 0 of 3 comma 1, the equation is 3t, 1 minus t raised to square. So we put the value of t 0.15, we will get this. 0 of 35, we will get this. In this way, we identify this column, find out this column and find out this column, and we will get this table. So the purpose of this table is to minimize the next calculation. Otherwise, in the next, every time you need to calculate this value of j comma 30 with this equation. So to simplify that, we are doing it. So once we get this table, the next task is to find and identify the values of PT. PT is the position vector on the curve. So it has two coordinates, x coordinate and y coordinate. So we need to identify the value of xt and yt. So where there are 7 points, t is either 0, t is either 0.15, t is either 0.35, 0.5, 0.65, 0.85 or 1. So we are going to calculate that xt and yt. So to calculate this xt and yt, the position vectors, the vertices on the polygon is given. What are these vertices? 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3 and 3, 1. So these vertices are given here. These are the vertices. Okay? Given 1, 1. Then this is 2, 3, this is 4, 3 and this is 3, 1. And we are going to find out the 7 points within these vertices so that we can draw a Bezier curve. So that we can draw a Bezier curve. So that 7 vertices we are going to identify here. Now to identify these 7 vertices, we need this 7 position vectors, we need these 4 vertices, and how we are going to use these 4 vertices, that we are going to see. Now the values of this 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 3, 1. So x0 is 1, x1 is 2, x2 is equal to 4 and x3 is equal to 3. That are the values we are going to put here. So b0, b1, b2 and b3. What is b0? It is the first vertex 1, 1. What is B1? It is the second vertex 2, 3. What is B2? It is the third vertex 4, 3. And what is B3? It is the fourth vertex 3, 1. It is not possible to calculate together. So we are first calculate for X, T and then we will calculate for Y, T. Now see how the calculations are there. Okay. So these are the vertices that we know. Next, I am going to calculate it for, I am going to find out 7 position vectors for x coordinate. So, first position vectors is for x of 0. First position vector is for x of 0. So, how to calculate it? For that, we are using this same equation. What is the equation? B0 J30T, B1 J31T, B2 J32T and B3 J13T. Okay. Now the values of J30, 31, T2, 33 already we have calculated, so not necessary to calculate it again. These values as it is we are going to put in the equation. And what is the value of X? It is B0, B1, B2, B3 means X0, X1, X2, X3. Simple. So put these values here. First value, this is our X0. This is our x1, this is x2 and this is y, x3. So that values 1 multiply with j of 30. What is j of 30 here? It is 1. J of 30 is 1. So multiply with 1 plus. Next b1. What is b1? B1 means x1, that is 2. Multiply with J of 3, 1. What is J of 3, 1? 0. So multiply with 0. Similarly, plus B2. What is X2? 4. Only X value we are considering in B2. X2. Multiply with 0. Plus 3. Multiply with 0. Why? Because 1, 0, 0. It's a 1, 0, 0. And when we calculate it, it is equal to 1. So x naught is 1 here. X naught is 1 here. In the same way, we are going to calculate x1. X1 is 0.15. Okay. Or I write here for your simplicity 1. X1 is 0.15. What is this? This is the value of T, 0.15. So when 0.15, what is the X0, X1, X2, X3, this is same. Now we need the value of j 30, j 31, j 32, and j 33. So when t is equal to 15, what is the value of j 30? This one, j 31, this one, j 32, this one, j 33, this one. So that values we are going to multiply with x naught, x 1, x 2, and x 3. So I am going to write here 1, x naught is 1 multiply with 0.614 plus x 1 is 2 multiply with 0.325 plus x 2 is 4 multiply with 0.058 plus x 3 is 3 multiply with 0.003. okay, so these values, whatever we have calculated, these values I put here and multiply with x naught, x 1, x 2, x 3, and then after this we will get the result 1.5. so the next point on the curve, the first point is 1 for x coordinate, the next point on the curve for x coordinate is 1.5. again I am going to show you one more example. Now the next x 0.35, correct, but the next t is 0.35. for simplicity I have written here the value of t directly. So 1 multiply with 1 is our x naught. What is the values for 0.35? When it is 0.35, the values for J30 is 0.275, 444, 0.239 and 0.042. So that value we are going to put here in this equation. So the first value is 1 multiply with 0.275 plus 2 multiply with 0.444 plus 4 multiply with x naught, x 1, x 2, x 3, same for all the coordinates that we are going to find out on x axis. So the next 4 multiply with 0.239. Then 3 multiply with 0.042, and when we calculate it, it is 2.245. So that is next coordinate or next coordinate on the x axis. 7 points we are going to calculate. So the next is x of, after 35, the next is 0.5. So I am going to write here the value directly. 0.75 is the next coordinate, sorry, 2.75. when I use it with x of 0.65, then the result will be 3.121. okay, so when x of 0.85, the result will be 3.248, and when it is x 1, the final end point, when t is equal to 1, the result will be 3. So start with the x coordinate 1, end with 3. So in the same way, we will calculate it for y. So first start with y. Y 0, we are going to first write here. Now for that, what is the value of y naught? 1, y 1, 3, y 2, 3, and y3 1. So start with y 0, t is equal to 0. So 1 as a y0 multiply with 1 plus second y1 is 3 multiply with 0 plus y2 is 3 multiply with 0. That are the values of j30, j31, j32 and j33 plus y3. Okay, y3, this value is 1. So 1 multiply with 0, the result will be 1. So the first point is 1. So in this case, the first point is also 1. And if you observe here, the first point on the vertex, correct, polygon, first point is also 1, 1. Why it is? Because it matches the first and last one. That is the property of the Bezier curve. So the we are going to see whether the last point also matches or not. The first point matches here with the polygon vertices. Now why? With 0.15. So here 1 multiply with 0.614. Again the same value that we have calculated here, that is 0.1614, 0.325, 0.58 and 0.003, that we are going to put here with y0, y1, y2 and y3. So plus y1 is 3 multiply with 0.325 plus 3 multiply with 0.0058 plus 1 multiply with 0.003. In the main we will calculate, the result is 1.766. Okay, so what is our y x0 y0 1 1? So the first point I am going to write here, the first point on the curve is 1 comma 1. The first point, that is x0 is 1, y1 is 1. So p0 is 1, 1, the first point on the Bezier curve. Now the second point, that is for t is equal to 0.15, x coordinate is 1.5 and what is y coordinate? 1.766. So here the when t is equal to, I have written here for your simplicity, p1, the first point when t is equal to 0, if I again, to understand, t is equal to 0, the point is 1.5 x coordinate and y coordinate is 1.766. That is our x1 and y1. That is our x1 and y1. That is point p1, the second point on the Bezier curve. Similarly, when we calculate the next one, y 0.35, we will get the result. I am going to write here the result directly. It is 2.366. So when y for this 35 means the third point, it is 2.3366 for y coordinate and what is x coordinate? 2.245. So it is when t is equal to 0.35, what is the x coordinate? X coordinate is 2.245 and y coordinate is 2.366. So that is our third point on the Bezier curve. That is y coordinate 2.366 and x coordinate 2.245. So here the next value of y is for 0.5, that already I have calculated, it is 2.5. So when 0.5, what is the value here? 2.75 for x coordinate and y coordinate 2.5. So when t is equal to 0.5, the x value is 2.5 and the y value is sorry, 2.75, and the y value is 2.5. 2.5. Okay. In the same way, next y 0.65 is equal to, it is 2.366, and y 0.85 is 1.766, and y1, okay, y1 is, if we put the values here in this table, y1, 0, 0, 0, and then 1 only, so 1 multiply with 1, it is 1, okay. So y1, now put that values in this point table. So here, when t is equal to 0.65, the x value is 3.121 and the y value is 2.366. When t is equal to 0.85, the x value, x coordinate is 3.248 and y coordinate is 1.766. And when t is equal to 1, the last point, it is, x coordinate is here 3, correct? And the y coordinate is 1, 3 comma 1. 3 comma 1. Now observe the first and last point. What is the first point on the curve? It is 1, 1. And what is the last point? It is 3, 1. So observe on the vertex whether it is same. 1, 1, 3, 1. Means the polygon vertex, whatever the given, the Bezier curve passes through the first and last point always. That is the major property of Bezier curve, that it passes to the first and last point. And when we perform the calculations, the results should be, you can cross check your calculations. If the first point is and the last point is same, 1131 as given in the vertices 1131, then your calculations are correct. So these are the 7 points on the Bezier curve. These are the 7 points on the Bezier curve. That I am going to show here with the diagram. All these calculations are here. So in this diagram, you can observe here, the first point is 1, 1. Okay. This is the vertex that already we have seen here in the previous. Now, what is the first point there? After the first point, the second point, it is 1.5. You can observe, it is, this is 1.5. For x axis 1.5, and for y axis it is 1.766. Then the third point is 2.245 for here something, it is not 1 minute, I will use the line. Okay, so the first point you can observe here, it is 1.5 and it is 1.766 something. The third point is 2.245. You can see here the 2.245, this third point, and for y coordinate it is 2.366 something. Okay, then the next point, it is 2.75 here and 2.5 here. Exactly 2.5 here. The next one is 3.21, whatever here, 121 and 2.366. So you can observe this one, 2.366, same, 2.366. Then next point is here, this one, and here in this way, 1.766, same. And last one is this one, 3 and 1. This is 3, sorry, not possible to draw here, 3, and here it is 1. in this way, here the Bezier curve is drawn with the help of these 7 points. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Within this convex hull or within this Bezier polygon vertexes given. 4 vertices are given and ask you to determine 7 points. So here with the help of this equation, you can draw the Bezier curve. You can determine 7 points, 8 points, 4 points, 5 points. Any number of points you can determine. So this is the equation which is written in the matrix form, the same equation written in the matrix form. Now where the Bezier curve is used? Nice stop today. So the Bezier curve applications, computer graphics Bezier curves are widely used in computer graphics to model the smooth curve. So B-spline curve, Bezier curve, these are normally used to generate the smooth curve. So in animation application mostly it is used. Because in animation it requires the smooth curves, hard curves or sharp curves are not allowed. So Bezier curves are used to outline, for example, movement. Font, true type fonts use Bezier spline composed of quadratic Bezier curve. True type fonts or in the fonts it is used, Bezier curve is used.